गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डूइंग लेसन 13th एमएस एक्सेल। लेट अस स्टार्ट। आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज वर्किंग विद द फॉर्मूलाज। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी कैन यूज द बेसिक फॉर्मूलाज एज वेल एज कंपाउंड फॉर्मूलाज। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द बेसिक फॉर्मूलाज एंड द कंपाउंड फॉर्मूलाज? सपोज यू आर यूजिंग द वन काइंड ऑफ द ऑपरेटर। एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेलिंग यू, as you know that every cell is having one address. For example, one cell, it may have the address B1, means B is the column name and 1 is the row number. Means every cell is having one address, and if you want equal B1 plus C1 plus D1 plus, it will automatically add the three values. Means whenever you want to add the values, you have to put the equal sign and after that the name of that cells, the address of that cells. This is the type of the basic formulas. And if you want to use the compound formula, here by mean of the compound is more than one kind of the operators. For example, whenever you are going to calculate the compound interest, in that case, compound interest or simple interest, for example, for calculating the simple interest, we are using P multiply R multiply T divided by 100. In this case, we are using two operators. Here, by mean of the operator is symbols, multiply symbol, divide symbol. More than one operators, it is a formula. And in the calculating interest, you can use the compound formula. Next concept is using ranges in the class. Dear students, you can use the range the formula also. Here by mean of the range that the address of the cells in the continuous ways. For example, the cells from the address B1 to the B10, then it is the range B1 to the B10. Cell reference. Whenever you are using formulas and in which cell you are getting the output and you are getting copy to that address wherever you want to paste, have you observed that what is going to be happened? Means wherever you are going to copy it in that cell, the address is going to change automatically. For example, in a cell C10, you are getting the result of sum of C1 to the C9 and you are going to copy it in the D10. What will happen? In the D10, you will automatically get the output of the sum of D1 to the D9. So, it is an example of the relative reference. And suppose you want to copy the address of the C1 anywhere else and you don't want to change the relative addresses. In that case, you can use the absolute reference or the mixed reference. And for using the absolute reference and the mixed reference, you have to put the dollar sign before the row number and the column number. Next concept is using simple functions. Functions are the predesigned formulas, and functions have required the arguments and structure. arguments, whatever the values you are giving inside the formulas, that are known as the arguments. And the structure, it is the basic method of the writing the formula. Some important functions are given here. Firstly, first function is sum function. So dear students, hopefully you may have used this one. The sum function is used to calculate the sum of the given range. How you will use it, I will do it practical, don't worry. And you just have to know that the sum function is used to calculate the sum of the given range. I will do the practical, I am again telling. And the next one is the average. Average function is used to calculate the average of the given range. Next one, count. If you want to count the values in the cells, you can use the count function. And in the count function, you have to give the cell range. Max. Max function is used to get out the maximum value of the given range. In the same way, you can use the min function also. Min function will bring out the minimum value of the given range. Today function. Today function print the current date of the system. In which cell you are using it, there it will be displayed the current date of the system. If function. If function is used to check the condition. And in the if function, you will use the condition and the two other values. And what will happen? Firstly, the condition will be checked, and after that, if the condition is true, first value will be printed, and if the condition is false, then the second value will be printed. Advanced features of the Excel. Dear students, the first one, advanced feature is here, sorting the data. Dear students, you can sort the data. Hereby mean of the sort is to print your data in the ascending or descending order. Ascending means you have to print your data count wise, like 1 2 3 4 5, or alphabetically A B C D, and in the descending you have to reverse the case. And if you want to do, you have to choose this button I am showing you. Sort button. You will find this button in the data tab. Firstly, you have to select the range where you want to sort the data, and after that go to a data menu, data tab, and choose a button sort. It will show you ascending or descending order. Last one concept of this lesson is filtering data. Filtering data is choosing the data from the given range. If you can choose the particular data from the given range, in that case you have to use the auto filter command. And when you will use the auto filter command, it will demand that what data you want to filter. You have to choose that data and automatically it will be filtered. So dear students, even though you face any kind of the problem, you can discuss with me. Thank you.